Hello everybody, welcome to SAS Global Forum 2020. Today, I'm going to discuss SAS Viya memory footprint analysis and reduction. My name is Zhiyong Li. I'm a principal software developer at Computer Services Division of SAS Institute. I've been with SAS for 19 years. I support Java and several other middle-tier technologies. I have a PhD degree in computer science from Duke University. I will cover the following topics: SAS 9 footprint overview, introduce the challenges of SAS Viya footprint, discuss Viya footprint reduction strategies, the current Viya footprint, and the comparison of Viya footprints across several different releases. I will conclude with a brief discussion on what we are doing right now to further reduce the footprint. SAS 9 is a traditional multi-tier web application. For the middle tier, all SAS products are deployed into a fixed number of web application servers or a fixed number of Java virtual machines, JVMs. For example, if you deploy SAS Enterprise Business Intelligence, or EBI only, your applications will be deployed into at most two web application servers or two JVMs. If you deploy SAS EBI plus SAS Enterprise Miner or SAS EM, your applications will be deployed into at most three JVMs. If you deploy all SAS products, your products will be deployed into 14 web application servers or 14 JVMs. By doing this, we avoid overhead of JVM footprint. We're able to run EBI plus EM in about 12 gig, and we're able to run EBI in about 8 gig. Also, we are able to keep the footprint ratio of middle tier at 75% of total footprint, and other tiers at 25%. Now, let's look at the Viya footprint. Viya still uses a multi-tier architecture. However, its middle tier is completely written using microservices. As you may know, each microservice runs in its own web application server, which in turn runs in its own JVM. With this architecture, SAS Viya Visual Analytics or VA ended with over 70 microservices and hence required 70 JVMs. SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning or VDMML ended with over 80 microservices and hence leads over 80 JVMs. Each JVM requires at least 300 meg, hence a big footprint challenges to our SAS Viya users. SAS Viya middle tier requires more memory. Further, it takes a high ratio of total footprint. For example, for SAS Viya VA, middle tier takes up to 92% of total footprint, and others now takes only 8%. Here are a few strategies for the footprint reduction. Some of them have been used over the course of Viya releases. For example, we have tuned microservices. We adjust the size of JVM heap for each microservice. We try the different GC algorithms and pick the appropriate one. We also adjusted other JVM options. The largest reduction comes from merging microservices. Our previous microservices are too fine-grained. We also noticed that if we restart microservices after initial deployment, we can see a fair amount of reduction. For example, we see about 4 gig of reduction for SAS Viya VA deployment. We also researched expanding jar archive. That can give us about 2 to 3 gig of savings for VA deployment. Using IBM OpenJLI seems achieved a large reduction as well. We have observed about 5 to 7 gig of savings for VI deployment. In the next couple of slides, I will show you some real footprint data and the footprint trend of the last few SAS Viya releases. This chart shows SAS Viya VA total footprint. You may notice there are three lines in the chart. That's because we take three sets of data points. One right after successful deployment, another is during the load test, and the third is after the load test. All three lines show the same trends. So let's focus on the black colored line, that's data collected during the test. You can see that at 18W30, which is Viya 3.4 release, the footprint is at about 38 gig. At 19W47 release, which is Viya 3.5, that number has been going down quite a bit. It is at 30 gig. After that, a few minor Viya 3.5 releases have a stable footprint. These slides shows the total Microservices footprint. It has a similar trend as the total footprint. However, it is about 3 gig less than that of the total footprint. The report on this slide shows the individual memory footprint. The rows are microservices and the columns are deployments. And the numbers in the table are the memory footprint in megabyte. You may notice that all of them is about 300 megabyte. This next chart shows the number of microservices over the course of the several Viya releases. We notice that we have 83 microservices at Viya 3.4, and that number has been reduced to 70 at the point of Viya 3.5 release. This reduction is due to the merge of microservices. The next four slides have the similar chart and report for SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning, or VDMML. This slide shows the total footprint for VDMML. This slide shows the total microservice footprint for VDMML. This slide shows the individual microservices footprint for VDMML. This slide shows the total number of microservices for VDMML. So, as of the last Viya release, the microservices footprint is still very high. One of the focused areas in the next few Viya releases is still memory footprint reduction. We will merge more microservices. However, we also found that microservices written in Go programming language have a much smaller memory footprint. It can reduce up to 80% compared with the Java microservices. Hence, we are doing a significant rewriting work. At the time of Viya 4.0.1 release, for VA, we expect 36 Java microservices are to be written in Go. For VDMML, we expect that about 43 Java microservices will be rewritten to Go. We expect a total footprint reduction for microservices can be over 35%. However, to make the expectation in check, Viya 4.0.1 is running in Kubernetes environment. The additional footprint is needed for the Kubernetes itself. Please keep looking at the Viya 4.0.1 release announcement. That will have a final official footprint number for Viya 4.0.1 release. That's all I have for my session. Thank you for tuning in. If you have any questions, please email me at Zhiyong sas.ni@sas.com.